Okay. You could see this is starting with a canvas that is little drops there. What it was an old canvas that I had started painting on and I didn't like the picture. So, we've all done that. So what I did was I took it and gessoed over it and then I collaged paper over it. So that's where I'm at right now with this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how I'm going to make this for Valentine's. That was my whole thing. I wanted to do some pictures for February. Helps me get through February. I love February as a month, but I've had some things happen in February that have dampened the joy of February. But I am born in February and then I was married in February. So just going to have some fun with February and work our way through it. Okay, so this is my February project. This was a canvas that I had drawn on and was starting a picture on and then did not like it. So I decided, well, I am going to do something about that because I don't like to waste canvases. I don't like to throw anything out that's a canvas. I mean, if it's a paper, that's something else, but if it's canvas, then I want to reuse it. So I just gessoed over the picture. I had just started it. It wasn't like it was full-blown finished picture. And then I decided, well, I'm going to use this and do a nice February project with it. So I took some paper, it's still wet, and I decoupaged on top, with decoupage and paper. And gonna let that dry, but in the meantime, I'm going to show you how I'm gonna make the hearts for this paper, for this project. Now, if you've seen my video on tile making with polymer clay tile, I do this in there. I take foil, and I'm just gonna use the foil as a. I'm just gonna mold the foil into the shape of a heart. Okay, so, and what I've done before, which is really cool, besides doing the clay tile over the foil and baking it, was I made the shape and then used, and I don't have any, otherwise I would be using it, plaster strips. You wet them and then you can run them over your form, whatever. Now I want to have. I'm going to do three hearts, one for each of my children, because they are the most important and the things I have loved the most in my, the people that I have loved the most in my life have been my children. I love my grandchildren too. I love them so very much, and they are a wonderful gift that you get from your children. But my children are my children. And I must say that my kids were great. I had a lot of fun with them. We had a great, great time together. So I love them, and I still love them. And I wanted to do something that represents my three children, and that I would have to look at. And if you have your children or your animals or your husband that a lot of us don't have children, but if you have your husband and your mother that you love, your father, somebody special, aunts, uncles, anybody, it's nice to either do something for them and make something or make something that represents the love that you have for them. So what I'm going to do here is now, there's my shape, and I'm going to make two more. Now I have my oldest daughter and then my middle daughter, my second child, my middle child, my lovely Jillian, and then I have my son. and they are all, the three of them, little darlings that they were. They were so much fun. They just were. My husband and I had a blast with them. Not going to be able to get them all the same shape, but a heart. This one, I took a little bit too much. Foil on that one, so I'm going to just cut that there. Just, you know, make it as good as you can. And I'm going to do the third one. This will represent my son. So I have Holly, Jillian, and now I'm going to have my son, Billy, who was a hoot and a half when he was little. Always mischievous, always, but very creative and loving and a wonderful kid. And he still is. They still all are. Amazing. And just keep playing with it. And they don't have to be perfect. This is mixed media. So we can have fun. So there we go. I've got three. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some plaster and I'm going to go over these with plaster. Okay, so now I'm going to take, actually this is modeling paste. So if you have plaster, whatever you have, you can use. I want this to be textured, so I am... this kind of whole thing is going to be textured. So I'm going to take the modeling paste and I'm just going to go over. And it works wonderfully if you're using those strips, the plaster strips, that works great too. Now, I've never used the modeling paste, so this is a first for me. We'll see how this works. And I want the whole thing covered the size. I'm not using this just as a form and then I'm going to pull it off like you can with the polymer. You know, you can use the foil as your form and then take it out once the polymer clay is cooked. But with this is going to be a permanent. So I don't know how many layers I'm going to have to do with this. I've used the plaster strips, but never the... I'll see if I can find a picture. I made a really cool chest. I was actually offered $2,000 for it, but it actually was for my granddaughter, so I couldn't sell it. So It had these. It has these hearts on it that I made from plaster, and it's tiled, and it has all kinds of stuff on it. I decoupage the inside. I mean, it really. But I used, the form made out of foil, like I just did, and then I use those plaster strips over it. And I don't even know how I don't think I even bought those plaster strips for the project. I think I had them. I don't know why, and I don't remember where I got them, and I'm sure you can get them on Amazon, but I just wanted to do this and didn't want to have wait. Although Amazon does deliver quickly, I just didn't feel like it. I wanted to try this. Okay. So I'm gonna let this dry. And then you can go over it again. If you want it chunkier and a thicker heart. Okay. I'm just going to keep doing it and building up, and I may have to open up another jar. And then we'll see how this dries and if I need to gesso over it or not. Now, once these are dry, you can decoupage over them, collage over them, whatever, paint them. Do whatever, but you'll have a nice textured heart. And this is very creamy. This molding paste from DecoArt. I keep going off, but I have to keep picking up some paste, molding paste. This is definitely like a paste. You need to reinforce your mold. You can always add more foil to it. See, now this one is kind of, so I'm going to just push it up a little bit. Just let that. And I love that it's textured. I don't know what I'm going to do yet to them, but I know I want this page textured, collaged, paint, stamped, all kinds of stuff. Okay, so I'll be back when these all dry and then we'll go from there. Okay, so we're back with this piece and you can see that it's kind of slick. So I'm going to be putting some clear gesso over it to it's got some bubbles in it, but that's okay because I'm going to be doing lots of textured things to it. So I'm just going to pour some clear gesso. This way, I still have the background. I can still see the background, but I've got a surface where if I decide I want to use watercolors, water crayons, watercolor crayons, whatever, I can. So you can do this with, if I could find a brush. Brush, a sponge brush, whatever. So I'm just going to go over the whole thing and then give myself a surface that I'll be able to use more products, different products on it, instead of just using acrylic if I don't want to. I don't know how much of this I really want to show, and I hope you can see that. See, it says, oops, mommy, right there. Let me fix that camera a little bit so you can see that. It says mommy. So I found that it was in one of the books. I have some of these children's books that are in really bad shape, so I've been just reusing the pages for collaging, not to, I got them in thrift stores and garage sales, and so they're kind of a mess, but some of the pages are, the colors are really pretty cool, so. So there you go. Okay, so now we can let this dry, and my hearts are still drying. I had to put them outside because this room, I guess, is very damp and humidity in here. So there we go. Okay, so next step will be hopefully working on, let me get some light on there. That helps. Be working on the hearts. And if not, if this dries before the hearts, I'll come back and we'll put some color on here. Oh, and what I wanted to show you, which is really cool, DecoArt has these things with these grooves in them to make texture and stuff, so we may be using those. I haven't even opened them yet, so that'll be fun. Let's see the mommy. Okay, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to water down some paint. And just do a wash over this. And some nice colors. Whatever you want. The gesso's dry. My hearts are still not dry. So we'll work on them in a little bit. So I just wanted to get some color in here. Kind of, whatever color you want to use. I want some nice bright colors in the background, so I'm just pouring it right on here. Just using craft paints, different paints that I have. I can still see the back, but, I'm playing, maybe some green, some of this green. It's really hard when you like all the colors, What do you want to pick? I don't know. So, I'm just... I need to get more baby wipes, guys. This is just my background. Nothing may not even be permanent. I don't know. You just never know. Just play. Now it has a little yellow. Now I'm using my hand, kind of smooshing it around. I want more of this back in here. I like that color. Add more of your colors. Oops, no. Wasn't that crazy? I did that. Okay, well, I'm going to use some of that anyway. I'm going to take that and not waste it because, that was just came out a little bit too fast. So I'm gonna get myself something that I wanted. I wanted to use that on something, so I'm gonna use it right now. I'll be right back. Okay, these are dry, but they're really very rubbery. Let me just make sure they're. So, I don't know, it's kind of weird. So I'm gonna go over them with gesso. I've never used anything, a paste. I guess it's a paste and not like a plaster. And I'm used to using maybe a plaster, and it's been, grainier, not so smooth. So I'm going over with white gesso and see if I can kind of, I don't know, give it the, let's see, give it the feel that I'm looking for. Okay. I need it to be rough, So if I want to collage on here, it'll stick. Also, if you want a watercolor or something, I'm not quite sure yet what I'm going to do, so I just don't want a smooth surface, that's for sure. So I'm just gonna paint over these with the gesso. Kind of thinking, all these things, thoughts are going through my mind, and I've got to wait and see what actually speaks to me and what on what I plan to do. Do I want to take tissue paper and maybe collage over it? That's an idea, huh? Some pretty tissue paper or napkins. I don't have a lot of I don't really have a lot of that stuff, but I can try and see if I could. I love napkins, but sometimes they're just so expensive, and I've got some from what's that place? Tuesday Mornings, but they really can get expensive. I know you can get a lot of uses out of a pack, but when you're trying to keep your supply costs down, you got to really pick and choose what you want. And I know we all have. We'd all love to go out and just spend money and buy all kinds of supplies, and sometimes you just can't, you just don't. You just don't. And since I am a working artist trying to make a living at art, it's you gotta pick and decide what are the items that you're gonna get the most bang for your buck with. What are you gonna use the most? Unless you're lucky enough to be making, tons of money at this. And then you can buy what you want. So I'm just going around, just and to those of you out there who are following your dream and doing your art, taking that leap, I commend you because I know it's
I'm going
hard.
to show you. I did find in the Americana watermelon slice. But it's a little bit darker than this one. This one's a little bit lighter, but I'm liking. I must have used it, or maybe I never. No, I didn't use it. So, I'm going to try using that later and see if it comes close. Because look, it's almost the same. This is just a little bit lighter. So I guess you add white and can make it a little bit lighter. But I'm glad I looked for it. So cool. So I have another bottle stash. Okay. So I'm going to hit this with a dryer and I'll be right back. Okay, you can see I smeared some on here and then I took some and put it on another piece of paper. And what I did was I took the brayer and took some from here and kind of smushed it through. So it's kind of all, I really love that color. So that was, you know, if you gotta take a little bit more than you wanted out of a color, then it should be a color hopefully that you like. So that's, let's see. Let me just adjust this camera. I think it needs to go out a little bit more. So let's just see. Now I have two webcam things. I have a Logitech camera setting and I also have just camera settings. So I had downloaded let's see. That's the focus. Okay, you got to go into advanced settings. Let's see if we can get it to darken up a little too. Yeah, it's a little bit better. And then that's more of the color that's on here. It was a little bit too light. And then let's see if I can. What does that do? That brings it in for more. That moves it over. That moves it over that way. Okay, so I guess that's as far as it can go out, the webcam. So unless I pull it up. Which thank good, oh yeah, that's right. I have this that goes up and down. You know, sometimes you forget things that you have. So that looks better. You can actually see the color a lot better now and see more of the whole canvas. So gonna let that dry, or we can, you know, hit it with a dryer and dry it. And then I'm gonna do some stamps on the back and maybe some crazy stuff and I don't know. Just something. But I'm loving the colors. I hope you are. I hope you're loving your colors, whatever you picked. Now I'm using, let's see, this is my studio, Seaside. I guess I used it before, I don't know when. And then I'm using cream coat watermelon. Oh, I love that color. So I mean these are old, so that's why I'm trying to use up some of my old stuff. And then I also use the Americana. And that is the chartreuse, which is one of my favorites. You can see it's a mess, but I love this color. And that's the satin. And I think, oh, and then the yellow, I use the Deco Art, the Traditions, which I love this paint. This is really one of their best acrylics. I love the Traditions. So those are the colors I used right now. And I just think that this watermelon just is dynamite. It's like a pinkish, orangish, reddish, whatever. I don't know how to make that color with paint. I'll have to find out. Maybe I can ask Cinnamon Cooney over at the Art Sherpa and see if she's got any ideas because I don't think I have this color exactly like this for any of my deco art and close to it, but just not it. You know, like. These are beautiful, like shrimp and let's see. This one's a little bit too orangey. You know, you really, it's like a pink, and this is too pink. You know, and I'm sure that I can make it. I just don't know how to make it. Oh, I like that color, paprika. Ooh, gotta use that on some. You have so many different colors that. I can't wait to get to my classes and start using all of these. Yeah, I can't find one that is like this color. And I'm going to have to, if I can't find it in my stash that's similar, I'm going to have to buy this again because I really love this color. So, It is watermelon and it's from Cream Coat. And what does that say? Delta. Delta, I guess, is the brand. Made in USA. So that's that. And I'll be back when this is dry. Okay, I'm going to start stamping. And what I did was, let's see, get some light on there a little better. I put a book underneath because, this canvas doesn't have a surface really to stamp unless you're just doing the edges. And I just got some stamps that I like for background. Nothing, just to, oh, it's not even. Let's see. Just to get some. Not looking, I'm just looking for some interest, not really for you to actually see, what it is. Maybe some of it. I love these numbers, and I'm gonna put them up here. The sides are okay. You can stamp on, and it's just that middle section. Numbers all over. I like just a little bit of the black added, Everybody has their favorite stamps, and these are definitely some of mine that I've used and used and used. Let's see, where's the book up here? This is my. I'm using Archival Ink Ranger. Not really caring if it's straight or not or whatever. I'm just kind of putting it in there for. You can still see the letters, the words from the paper. That's good. Now the hearts are going to be on here, and I don't know exactly where. So, I don't know what's going to be showing and what's not going to be showing, but that's good. That's good enough. Got some fun. Just a little texture. I still have beads floating around here. I keep thinking that bugs are walking around. And it's these little beads from my that other project with the tile. And just like, I thought I got them all, but I didn't. So, if you want to add more color on top of this, but I'm okay. I'm gonna just leave it for now. And then what I want to do is I'm just gonna put a little bit of ink. Just try and run some ink down here. See if it even runs. Sorry, I'm holding this up, but it's not really running. So, kind of see it. I'm just looking for some black ink to run down, and I'm gonna have to stand this up because otherwise it's not gonna run down straight the way I want it. And I actually am adding some water to the ink because it just wasn't flowing enough. I'll let you see. It's just hard to see it because you can't the camera. So there. So just ran some black ink down it, India ink. And of course you could do a lot more than that, but
that's what I've got. And I like that. There's some free form lines there, and we'll hit that with the dryer. And then I'm gonna see if my lovely hearts are dried, because I can't wait to play with them too. So, and I don't know what else I'm gonna do on here. I know I'm gonna write some things. I want it to be a little bit sentimental, so gonna write in it, but I don't know yet what I'm going to write. It's actually for myself, so I'd have to make three if I wanted it to be for the kids, and I don't know. They have so much of my stuff that I don't even know where else they would put stuff. So it's just not that they wouldn't want it. It's just that, they surely don't need any more things to hang in their house, and I know they love it, but they've got their kitties things. So I'm trying to clean out this little scooper thing because I don't want to put it back into the ink. And this is the Soho fast drying ink, general purpose. And it is pretty fast drying. I may not even be able to have to hit it, but I'm gonna hit it with a heat gun, and then I'll be back. Okay, what I'm doing is making a mess, but adding some more of the color in with my finger, just around the sides and in here, just brightening it up a little bit, kind of pushing the original first colors back a little bit, and letting this kind of go through. I'm just cleaning and making piggy messes, but I just wanted it a little bit brighter. And I'm totally into these colors, so just adding not a lot, just because I don't know right yet where the hearts are going to go. So I want to make sure that these colors stand out. So, that's probably it for now. So that's good. It's kind of splashed there. And we got the black, and now I'm gonna probably, I'm sure, doodle on this and just let this dry, and then I'm gonna get the hearts in at least to see where I want to place them so I can figure out what I need to do with the rest of this. Okay, so we've got the three hearts and they are dry, and you can see that I the stencils that I did. So I'm going to paint those and let's see how it goes. There were a little bit. So what I'm going to do with those, I think I'm going to take my paper, my napkins, and I don't know yet. Or I may use different paper, or I just may paint them and then texture them and not even put any paper on it because I've got things busy back here. So first I want to paint these little flowers. So I'm going to get some paint for that. See that I painted the flowers and the kind of like the lily pads there, and I'm gonna go over them again and do them a little bit different, but
just think they're really looking cool. And then I'm gonna come back and get these hearts. Figure out what I want to do with the heart. Well, I think what I'm gonna do first with the hearts is actually paint them. This needs to dry, so I'm gonna put this over to the side, and then get the hearts. Let's just get the hearts and start doing them. And okay, so I did one with just the paint, one with black gesso, and one with mixed in with the paint and matte medium. So, just wanted to see what I would want to do to each one. I'm gonna let them dry and then kind of figure out. I don't know, and I'm out of baby wipes. Yucky yucko. And I'm gonna clean this up a little bit, and then I will be back when they're all dry, when everything's dried.
Okay, you can see that I have colored the hearts, and I kind of make each one different. This was the black one, so I added, sponged on some color here. And then this one was the one I put paper on this one. I gotta kind of trim that off. I sponged some color on that one, and this one I sponged some color on this one. Now I'm going to do more to them, but I just wanted to get some idea. I kind of like it. Kind of like that. Maybe. And going to put some white in this. And it's gonna look, I'm gonna love this in my room because I'm gonna hang it in here in my studio. I need some color in here, and I've got some pictures that I'm gonna hang up in here. I don't have that much wall space, but I'm gonna try and hang as much as I can. Besides, I'm doing the doors, so, but I thought this is gonna be really colorful, so. I'm not ready yet to glue these down because I think I'm still going to work on the background a little bit. I'm trying to think. I want to pull in some white, but I'm trying to think. Do I think I'm going to use white acrylic, but what exactly do I want to stencil on there? And I love the punchinella. That is, one of my faves. To do some of that, and I think that will probably be what I do. And I don't know, I have so many stencils, I like to use them. I think that I'm gonna do that for now, and just I have made such a mess with this project. I think this is one of my messiest ones. I have just made a mess. Okay. So let me see. Let me get some white paint, which we have. Let's see. Here's white birch. Some of this. Ooh. Gotta be careful. You have to shake them, but then when you shake them, you gotta be careful because, they shoot out on you. Just kind of randomly. And the white works really good, and you make it as dark as you want, as light as you want. But sometimes you just need some white accent just to brighten up the page a little bit.
And it works really good with the punchinella, and it's like all different sizes. Kind of see how that brightens it up quite a bit, and then you can do the same thing to your, bring it into the hearts if you're doing that, and continue it onto there. But I don't know, the hearts, I'm going to put this over to the side so this dries, and then the hearts, I still have not gotten baby wipes. Have to go and get them. Okay, so the hearts. I'm thinking I may spray something, do a stencil, and it's gonna be hard because they're not, they're not really flat. I was thinking of spraying, but we'll see. This one is probably flattest, so let's see what I'm going to do on there. It's going to have to be something that really shows well, when you spray. Gonna try to get a design on it. Let's see, kind of that. Something like that. I don't know if it'll. Let's see my spray colors. Now, if my sprayers would work properly, then yeah, it's just sometimes they do not. This one does, so let's see. Kind of made a mess. Didn't really. I like the color, so I'm gonna leave it, but it didn't really show up the design, so. I'm just gonna clean it off onto this paper towel because I use my paper towels to make things. I'm just gonna let that kind of dry. I do like the green, the way that showed up there. Does it take a little bit off? I hate when it puddles. Don't like puddling. And that is pretty, even though I didn't get the design I wanted. At least I got the color. This one. Let's see, what do I want to do with that one? That's another one. I'm probably, if I want to get any kind of design on here, I'm going to have to do with the sponge because spraying it is not gonna do it. And let's see. The leaves would be really pretty if they, if I could get them on there. So let's see. And I may be really looking for a little bit too much. Well, it gives it a little bit of color, a little bit different. I'm going to wind up painting over that, because that's not really what I want. I'll leave the design there and just paint over it. Too, but
Okay, I'm trying to get the colors a little bit on this camera to show up a little bit. Wind up seeing a shadow here because I've got the light coming in from behind me from the door. But you can see that I did went over those leaves, don't like, and I'm going to go over them again. And I put some of these what are these called? These, oh, I can't think. They're acrylic satin, whatever. They like glisten, and I don't know the name of them. I don't know the brand. I threw the paper out that came with the box because they don't have it marked on these. But they're oh, glazes. That's what they are. Acrylic glazes. So I'm using them and adding more color to this, and just did some on there. That looks way more redder than it is. It's actually a little bit more orangey. Let's see if I can adjust this a little. Yeah, it's just a little bit too intense, too bright. Let's see if I darken a little bit. You can see that that one has. I put this orangey one on there, and it's called Spice Pumpkin. That's kind of like my favorite one. But and then I ran some of it through. I put the what is this? Snapdragon. This purpley kind of color on. This is actually. It looks blue on the camera, but it's actually very purple. And then this one is Jasmine, and that's like a pinky purpley, and the gold. Emperor gold. I used that kind of. I think I used all of these in here. So I just added more. I'm gonna have to put some more white in here because it's a little bit too dark. So I will, and I'm gonna glue these on. And I think once I get these glued on, then I will doodle some more and then figure out where I want to put some white and stuff. And then I'll be done. Okay, you can see I cut out the words, typed them out for love, forever love. I mean, I think that's what a mother's love is, forever. So I'm just gonna use a little bit of some ink, distress, whatever they call this, ink, and just put some different colors on it. Make it pop out. I'm just gonna put the word. I'm not really very wordy with my project, so but for this one I thought I'd just put a couple words. And then I think I'll go around the edges with a black. So I used, what did I use? Picked raspberry and peeled paint. Got me. So I'm just gonna do some black around it. Then just glue it down.
And that'll be that. And then I will have it to hang on my wall and remember my darling, three darling children, who are my favorite people in the whole world. So let's put that there like that, and I think I'm done. So this was lots of fun. I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll show you the end result at the end. I'll show you a picture of it after I get this all glued down, but I just want to say thank you so much for being here, and please don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. Hopefully I inspired you to do something like this, whether it's for your children, your grandchildren, your pets, your loved one, your husband, your friends, whatever. Just to, you know, have something to look at that reminds you of your favorite people. So I thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.